Let's say you're traveling abroad and putting your passport in the safe of your hotel room, so you don't have to worry about it and carry it with you on your travels. You are putting trust into a system that you think works. It wasn't a safe you bought, and you're not entirely sure what practices the hotel follows to make sure it is reliable to keep there. When research participants share data with us, it is exactly like that. Research participants are putting trust in us to keep their information safe and secure. As data collection and dependence on the internet have risen, so have data breaches and cyber threats. Research participants are more vulnerable than ever, especially as researchers conduct remote usability tests, use third-party applications, or store and share data online. Today, we're going to talk about 6 best practices to follow before data collection begins and during and after data collection happens. The first 3 we'll talk about are relevant before data collection. When you first create a research plan, you should establish a data management process. Create guidelines around how data should be collected, stored, protected, and shared with others. Having a designated person editing and updating these guidelines as laws and company policies shift helps keep this streamlined. While developing your research plan, you also want to develop a data collection plan for preserving participants' confidentiality. This starts with understanding privacy laws and using it as a guiding framework when developing a data collection plan. Then, ask yourself the following questions always. First, do I really need to collect this identifiable data? Will this data affect my results? Second, ask yourself, what tools should I use to collect data safely and securely? Teams need to decide which tools to use before data collection to avoid having data stored in multiple places. Let's talk about informed consent. Informed consent creates a two-way street between the researcher and the participant, where researchers inform participants the details of their involvement in the study. This communication is typically presented in a consent form. Our next 3 best practices are relevant during and after data collection. First, let's talk about how we maintain participant anonymity. Anonymity should be preserved while taking notes, while cleaning data and preparing it for storage, or while disseminating results. For example, don't use participant names or any other key identifiers like social security number, date of birth, in notes and file names. When we get to the point of sharing data, you want to make sure you're sharing files in a secure way only with those people who really need them. Researchers should not collect and share data on cloud storage services because you don't have complete control over that data. Instead, researchers should consider using an external drive to storing encrypted data. After you've collected data, delete data that is no longer needed. It can be tempting to hold on to data, but one of the best ways to protect data is to delete it once you are done with it. Information around how long data is kept should have also been communicated to participants. As researchers, we have an obligation to follow through with initial guidelines we communicated to the participants. Maintaining participant data and privacy and security should be a priority for all researchers. While participant data is important to us, it is even more important to them. As researchers, we need to do our part to make sure their data is safe and secure.